Hey, everybody. Welcome to No Jumper News. It's Adam 22 here with your man, AD. Let's get right into these stories. So first things first, Krishan Rock has been Blueface's artist for some time, but recently it has been made clear that the two are no longer working with one another. Earlier this week, video footage surfaced online showing the altercation at Blueface's home, where Blueface and WAC 100 attempted to get Krishan to leave the residence. The cops were eventually called to help the situation, and much of the incident transpired while on Instagram Live. WAC can be seen telling the people that he wants Krishan out. However, she refuses to budge, and while plenty of live stream and viral clips circulated online, the conclusion of it all is kind of unknown at this point. During the conversation, WAC actually explains why Krishan was fired.
I work. What are you talking about?
You work what? What do you do?
I'm an artist.
Work where?
What are you talking about?
You work where? You pay
a bill? I work for
you. You don't work for He what? Dropped you a week ago. 2 weeks ago. He dropped you.
He didn't just drop me.
Can you explain to her that I have the right to say, I don't want to do business with you. You're free to go.
I don't live here for free, she screams out in the video. I work. To which WAC 100 replied, you work what? What do you do? She then replies, I'm an artist, man. What are you talking about? I work for you. WAC responded, you don't work for shit. He dropped you a week ago. 2 weeks ago. He dropped you. WAC then becomes aggressive as he speaks for Blueface, saying, the owner here ain't going for it, while police attempt to maintain calm. In another video, officers can be heard telling WAC 100 to slow down as he attempted to explain the law. Apparently, Rock couldn't be evicted without notice according to local land laws. Since the incident, Krishan has continuously resurfaced on social media with posts about the conflict and Blueface. She claims that she isn't trying to be messy. Instead, she just wants to say what she's got to say in the face of the controversy. On Instagram Live, Krishan explained that she refused to leave because she wanted 30 days like any other eviction. She admitted that she escalated the situation, and later she wrote that she's 21 years old and is learning from her mistakes. She also said that she has relocated to an apartment. Blueface has stayed silent throughout the drama this week, but he recently stepped forward to tell his version of events.
I told Krishan it's done with. Like, she was getting a little too out of hand for me, and it wasn't, for me, her work ethic wasn't there enough for me to cope with her crazy life decisions and the way she think and act and move.
Blueface claimed that he arranged for her to live somewhere else, but she would continue to come to his place. While there, she would want to jump in the pool, but he said that he reminded her that they had business to handle. He also added that he told Krishan he was filming at the house and told her to leave, but when she got back to her place, she broke windows, causing the police to be called to that location. I guess that this is, in some ways, a sort of fitting end to the tale of Blueface and Rock. I mean, probably a lot of people, myself included, were kind of confused about exactly what he was doing with her and what this signing of her was going to turn into. And it turns out that it turned into a whole bunch of headaches and her showing up and breaking windows at his house, which is unfortunate. But I guess we probably all could have kind of predicted that it might have ended this way, right?
Yeah, man, I feel real bad for her, man, because seems like she really loves that man. Like, she's obsessed with him. He keeps telling her, stop getting my name tattooed and stuff like that. So the fact that she won't leave and she doesn't want to leave and stuff just shows that she's just real connected with this man, and she doesn't want to have to part ways, even though that it was a business endeavor.
Yeah, I mean, I feel like Blueface is someone who has a little bit of that thing inside him where he wants to take somebody from a bad background or whatever, and he wants to, you know, help them in their life and make everything peachy keen for them. And I don't know, sometimes it feels like you just bite off a little bit more than you can chew. You get somebody who's maybe got some issues that aren't going to necessarily go away. I mean, I don't feel like her music career really blew up like the way that maybe she would have expected or anything like that. I don't know. I'm kind of just saying that. I don't know how many numbers she did or whatever. I do wonder, though, if there is life after Blueface, like if she's going to find another spot.
Yeah, she's entertaining. Yeah. I think she could do her own thing. I think she could be successful with it if she focuses. So, hopefully everything works out for her. Hopefully she can do good things.
Well, I know another crip with a label who maybe would be happy to sign her.
Who are you referring to? Next story. Questions are swirling about the motive behind the early morning attack that left philanthropist Jacqueline Avon dead in her Beverly Hills home. Beverly Hills police initially described the Wednesday incident at the couple's home in Truesdale Estates as a home invasion. But Beverly Hills Police Chief Mark Stainbrook later suggested that the couple may have been deliberately targeted, rather the victim of thieves just looking to rip off the rich and famous. Obviously, someone went into the home. We just don't know what the purpose was, Stainbrook told reports late Wednesday. A lot of times, people think home invasion when it comes to robbing or burglarizing a residence. I think there are a lot of nuances to the term home invasion. I don't think it's a random attack, but I can't speculate that right now, he said. The 90-year-old icon was with his 81-year-old wife, Jacqueline, when home invaders stormed in the early morning hours. Footage from the scene showed a shattered sliding glass door, and according to the Los Angeles Times, at least one suspect got into the home before gunshots rang out. But it was not clear how many robbers were involved. It also remains unclear if anything were taken from the residence. The circumstances surrounding the shooting also remain murky, but police have said both Clarence Avon and a security guard were at the home during the apparent invasion, though they were unharmed. Jacqueline Avon, 81, was found at the scene with a gunshot wound after police received a call just before 2:30 a.m., and she died from her injuries shortly later at the hospital. Investigators reportedly hope the security cameras throughout the neighborhood will help them piece together precisely what happened. In the meantime, the news of her death has left many in the entertainment world shocked with grief.
I mean, this story right here is just maybe the most brazen example that we've heard of in a while of all these fucking insane home invasions that are happening all over Los Angeles right now. And I guess if I had to say one thing, and I'm sure that the kind of people who do this kind of thing maybe aren't just sitting around listening to my podcast, but leave the women out of it, you know, leave the kids out of it. Like, stop running up in people's homes. This shit is all fucked up. And I know it ain't gonna do nothing by us saying this, but please, people, just have some more respect for human life, because having to hear about this dude losing his wife at 90, I mean, that's just like an unspeakable level of cruelty just to think about that and him having to deal with that. So, I mean, he don't know me, I don't know him, but prayers up to him, because that's some terrible shit, and I hate seeing LA come to this.
Bro, this is very disgusting. You know, the basic rules, man, men, women, children always should be off the table. Los Angeles is getting too crazy, you know what I'm saying? It's just people are afraid to go out and eat now. If a 90-year-old person and an 81-year-old can't be at home by themselves at night without having to worry about some shit like this, bro, it's very disgusting. And, you know, man, this I blame this pandemic money, man, over everything, bro. It just seems like everybody got a taste of what it was like to have, you know, large amounts of money. And now that it's ran out, people don't want to go back to living regular lives instead of working hard like, you know, you're supposed to do to live the type of life that you want. Taking it from somebody ain't the way to go. Prayers to their family. This is a terrible, terrible incident that should never happen. It should never happen again.
And if you smoke an 81-year-old lady, there's a special place in hell for you.
For sure.
Or I hope a special place in the prison where they'll beat the dog shit out of you for doing some shit like that, man.
Yeah, it need to be more than that to happen. So, yeah.
YouTube. Like, comment, and subscribe, and we will talk to you real, real soon. Appreciate you.